morning, good girls and boys. Welcome to the show. This is Tin City. I'm your Sully Humphrey. By now, you guys must know my intro. It's the same, fam. It never changes. Because I'm smiley like that, yeah? All right. Well, good morning. I like you guys. I love you guys for supporting the show and making sure you wake up and, you know, loving the show, coming in on Facebook, Instagram. Even Instagram, yeah, DMs. I appreciate the guys who come through and slide in and, you know, tell me their comments. And of course, the guys who have school events, fam, you guys are awesome. I'll keep the invitations coming through. The guys already, I'm already booked almost the entire first term for guys who have proms. Yeah, St. Lawrence, I'm coming through. I have a couple of others. I have Mary Hill. Jesus, there are very many. I would keep them coming through. And for the guys who always wonder how you can have Tin City and Swag Magazine for that matter to come through for your school event, it's very easy. Come down to New Vision, ask for Humphrey. Even if you want to come by and just say hi, fam, if I'm around, I'll come downstairs and, you know, I'll holler at you and take a selfie. Yeah, so do not feel shy. Yeah, do not feel shy. I appreciate the guys also sliding to my DMs or just asking me a couple of questions. You want to do TV, you want to know how to navigate the career, how to enter, penetrate TV, you know, as a whole industry and, you know, sort of like hobby or whatever the questions are, I'm very much happy to actually reply them. All right, yo, let's get down to the show because Tin City starts now. All right, well, let's get into the show. The first part of the show is the launch. The launch, you know what goes down, topical discussions about different topics, and this one only gets better. And like I told you guys a couple of weeks back, and I continue to tell you guys, if you want to be on the launch, it's very simple, yeah? Just slide into my DM and tell me, hey man, I want to be on the launch next week. Or I want to be on the launch sometime. What can I do? And then I'll tell you guys what's up, all right? I can only tell you then when you actually DM me. Yeah, slide into the DM and request, all right? Without much further ado, let's get it started. The launch starts now. In literally every high school life, there's a senior or even a junior who is like the queen bee. You can call her the slay queen, yeah? It's either just one person or it's a whole clique of two, three, four people, even five, who always do everything together. They have their bed arranged a certain way, you know, flowers and all pink and whatnot. Their stockings are always neat and white. You know, they seem to have a problem. If they don't have asthma, they have surgery. When they cane me, I faint. You know, so if everyone is picking rubbish, if I picked one and I just get an infection or whatever, you know, they always have an issue and they are the actual high school queen bee. As a topic today, we're going to be talking just endlessly and aimlessly about them because we just love talking, yeah? This is Tin City. I'm your Sully Humphrey, Radio Urban TV, and the launch starts now. I have my awesome people again. They haven't changed clothes because, well, not that they don't have clothes, it's just that they love their clothes anyway. That's not an issue, yeah? What's your name?
Introduce yourself again.
My name is Ashley Olivia.
Yeah, Ashley Olivia. You don't have any other joke dude, mac dude?
I ever.
Oh, yeah.
And I'm Nasra, yeah. Mosa.
Lynette. Lynette who?
Lynette Asimwe Lia.
Exactly, that's a nice name. Why do you keep it? You know, when someone doesn't tell me the other name, I feel like, yo, it's one of those bombshell names. Like, you know, you say it's like as if you've cast a spell, you have to look out for ghosts coming through. Yeah, but this is actually, these are nice names. So we just say it, Lynette Asimwe, that's a very nice name, yeah? All right, now talking about high schoolers, slay queens, yeah, the queen bees. First of all, are you a slay queen, though? Were you a high school slay queen?
No, I wasn't.
I was a
normal high school girl.
You know, they are pointers. What kind of stockings were you guys wearing in your school? A Seroma, right?
White
stockings, eh? How often were they brown?
Brown? Yeah. They were never brown.
High school slay queen?
No.
Yeah. An average slay queen, of course, sometimes has like a hole or it's brown at some point. Come on. how good were the meals? What meals do you have? Like the one that took up the most time, like every day. Meal? Yeah.
The usual thing, rice, meat.
Oh, you only went there when it was rice, that's what you think.
Uh-huh, yes.
Exactly. Slay queen, high school slay queen. Let's talk now. That's right. I got you. Where high school slay queen now?
Nope.
Why do you think you're not?
Because I'm casual. Those guys have to live to standards, these high standards, which I can't.
Oh yeah.
they don't, you don't do, you know that, you know in high school, most of the time those are usually, you wear a tie and uniform, yeah? You know, let me ask you, did you, how tight or loose was your tie?
No, we had cravats.
Cravats. Or how tight or loose was your...
It was always supposed to be there.
There?
You don't have to loosen it, tighten it, it's just there.
All right, come on, there's no time at all where your upper button was just, like, loose.
Nah.
But you guys have had an experience like the slay queen in school, yeah? Of course, now that girl is always, she's always actually called a hot girl. Though, in my time, I think there was this girl who was, she was called, can I say the name though? I'll use another name. She's called Ashley. Yeah? Now, Ashley was this hot girl. She was light skinned though. Very light skinned and very slightly, you know, those model sizes and whatnot. She was like, she knew herself. Yeah? Even as the kind of shoes she had for uniform were like were the one with the heels that make noise. Every time you walk through the hallway, all classes have to look outside the window like, ah, that's Ashley walking. So this one time she actually slept off in class and she farted. And not the farting that is really funny. The farting that like goes like That's when she lost it. She lost all of it. So she has so much of a slay queen that she never thought that situation was like would ever happen to her. And the thing is, she was so much of a slay queen that even us didn't think she was normal enough to even fart. Like whoever knew a slay queen would fart. So that entire year she was at the lowest, that so much that she had to even change school. Yeah, we didn't do our finals with her. She changed school, like she couldn't handle it. Yeah, so have you had a slay queen in school? Like, how is she? How is it? How are they like? What kind of privileges do they, you know, have? Because I understand some schools, even some slay queens have privileges. Sometimes they can't even eat in the staff room.
Yeah.
And teachers are like, I know you come through, it's okay. You have some of the teacher's food. What kind of slay queens did you have? And it was Vienna, yeah? What kind of slay queens did you guys have there?
Okay, they would like to like do like okay, they are prefects most of the time. You know, like when
most
you
of the time the queen bees are prefects.
Yeah.
Aye.
Me, that's like to me.
Okay.
Me, what from my perspective.
Yeah.
Yeah, and though you know when you're prefect, you feel like you can boss everyone around.
Yeah.
Yeah, but literally, as in Vienna, like I feel like everyone was equal.
Right.
Like you couldn't like, I don't know. I think. Okay, me, I used not to mind about that stuff. Okay, but they're mostly prefects.
Mostly prefects?
Yeah.
All right. Now, so ever had, you know, slay queens, queen bees in your school?
They're always there in every school. One, two, in each class, maybe.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, each class, eh?
No, like...
But it makes sense, actually, because I don't think a slay queen, a high school queen bee would actually be doing sciences.
It would be hard.
Yeah, because any girl doing that science has less time to think about how she would look like. Yeah, no offense. But did you do sciences? Yeah. Oh, you did sciences.
Science.
Oh, yeah. Was your college dirty though? Because I'm told
no.
You have no time to watch.
I did arts, yo.
You did? Oh, I thought you did sciences though. Oh, so what kind of privileges did your slay queens, queen bees used to, you know, enjoy?
I don't know. I don't know that they used to bribe these teachers.
Yeah.
But you know they would be favored something like that. Be, now those schools that used to came, they'll be there and you're older and you're like, okay, you go or meet me in the staff room later. You're becoming an issue. And you're like, but
so they get canes everyone until the high school slay
queen.
Yeah,
and then she moves in that, she'll be like, yeah, I know I'm sorted. And I'm not going to be cane, so you guys, yeah, they would want to be different from the rest. Not normal.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, in school it was supposed to be normal, but geez. Ah, like they would study different things from what we would.
Yeah, Lynette, yeah. What kind of slay queens are, you know, did you ever see in your time, high school? You know,
we said.
Yeah.
Like we literally actually collided with the same slay queens.
Yeah.
Like Feather. Boy, then you go down the game. And then we need certain. Like see me in the staff room after. Oh, go and wait for me at the staff room. Okay.
I think some teachers would even be so bold.
Yes.
I remember a situation where a teacher was caning everyone and was actually like real wagging, like with all the energy. You could see the guys swinging and you hear the sound until the stroke actually got your bottoms. But on reaching the like a slay queen, he's like,
I know, like,
And everyone is like, ah, sir, come on, come on. And the guy is like, do you want more? So you keep quiet and like, ah, oh, kawa. You know, I think it's, I do not know. Do you think people should actually report and make these complaints when there are slave queens, there are queen bees in school getting favored? Most of the time, women had this situation where, you know, teachers come and dictate notes, you know, during the class and whatnot. What they would do, they'd actually give the queen bees the books. So during the night prep before, they're actually copying the notes and whatnot. So they're copying the notes in advance. So the following day, the guy comes to dictate the notes. They already have everything. So what they are doing is sleeping in class. And they're enjoying all that privilege and actually feel really bad. Yeah. Sometimes they don't even make lines, you know, for meals and whatnot. Yeah. What do you think should be done? Do you think they should be reported? Because I tend to believe everyone should be equal, yeah?
No, but high school is like that. There is, even though you report, like, there is nothing going to change. Like, it's just the way it is. You cannot be equal. Yes. Like, the slay queens are there.
It's even worse when the slay queen is even a boy.
Hey, I'm telling you.
It happens, by the way, there are slay queens who are actually boats, yeah? Yes. But of course, boats in literature and whatnot, you know? and English and history and, you know, geography and whatnot. Yeah, and of course, not in math and whatnot, yeah? So, do you think they should, do you think it should be a level ground? Don't you feel like your morale and confidence is put down if one of your fellow girls is actually being favored more? Because, first of all, just being hotter than you, you're going to feel bad. Then I guess she's getting all this good.
Yeah, but me personally, I don't let them get to.
Yeah, you sound like the person who used to be in your. You know those people in school. You know those people in school, like when you actually finish Form 6, someone points and tells you that girl was actually in our class, and you're like, I never saw her, really.
No.
I'm feeling many people in your school didn't know you.
No.
They're like, she's from Vienna, we didn't know her.
Like, okay, they knew me because I used to dance a lot.
Oh, yeah.
That's all they knew
but
me.
Off but off the stage, like, you'd be an introvert.
Yeah. Like, okay, I would socialize, but like, there's something I really wouldn't pay attention to. Like the queen bees. Me, I take people, like, we're all equal.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, maybe it comes. If
so there's never a moment where you saw a couple of girls, you know, the popular ones, ish, you know, being favored and whatnot.
No. For me, from my perspective,
Everyone was about the same.
Yeah.
All right, that's what's up. We are just closing down the launch, but the conversation, of course, goes on, doesn't just stop here. You can get in on the fun on our Twitter, it's on Urban Television, and also Facebook, Urban Television or Teen City. Like the pages and get in on the fun. We appreciate you guys. And of course, if you want to be here, it's very easy. Just come through to Urban TV and ask for the producer. That is Alinda Munanura. She'll be waiting for you. And also, you can even ask for me, guys, okay? You can ask for Humphrey, but you might actually knock. One of those are on, yeah? But you can just come through and ask. Or you can even slide into our DMs or my DM. It is on, the good way, slide into the DM, the good way, on Instagram. And make your request, yeah? It's okay. You can slide into DM and say, hey, what's up? I want to be on the booth anytime. And, you know, I'll shoot you up. It's all good. It's all love, all right? We're going for a short commercial break. We'll be right back. This is Till Teen City, right here on Urban TV. Welcome back from the launch. We're going for a short commercial break, but a lot of fun is still coming your way. So stay tuned. Do not tell. This is Still Teen City, right here on Urban TV.